to my Mexican kitchen here in Switzerland. Today the recipe I'm going to share is I've tasted it in my mother-in-law's house. She makes these amazing cookies, which I adore. I really, really love them. And she makes them during Christmas time because the ingredient we need to make them is just found in winter. And in case you don't know it, it's a blood orange. How freaky is this? Honestly, I remember I grew up in San Francisco and then I moved to Mexico to study high school and university. And I never got to see these in San Francisco or in Mexico. And my husband bought oranges one day. He never told me what a blood orange was. And then he goes off to work and I wanted an orange. So I started opening one and then I saw this and I threw them all in the garbage. I was freaked out, like, what is this? What happened to the oranges? Later on, he explained the whole process of how blood oranges are made and blah, blah, blah. But going back to the recipe, these cookies are so yummy. The issue is, I don't know if you guys can find blood oranges wherever you live. You need a certain type of climate for this effect to happen to oranges. If you don't have blood oranges, you can use regular oranges. But if you do find them in your supermarket, use them. They are amazing. The ingredients you need to make your blood orange cookies are 500 grams of flour, the equivalent is 3.5 cups. 160 grams of sugar, the equivalent is 3/4 of a cup. 250 grams of butter, the equivalent is 1 1/8 of a cup. 1/2 gram of baking powder, the equivalent is 2 pinches. 1/2 gram of salt, the equivalent is 2 pinches. 4 egg yolks. 2 tablespoons of blood orange juice, the zest of 2 blood oranges. For the glaze, you're going to need 150 grams of confectioner sugar, the equivalent is 1 cup, and 1 to 2 tablespoons of blood orange juice. Okay, so before we get started, there's 2 ingredients that I ask for 2 pinches on each one, and many people may have a different perspective of what a pinch is. So if you have a measuring spoon, there's some very precise measuring spoons which are super tiny. In my set, a pinch is this spoon, this is my pinky finger. You can see how tiny it is. It's hardly anything. And if you don't have these types of measuring spoons, what you usually do is, whoops, where did I put it? Over here. You grab whatever dry ingredient you're going to use, and with a little knife, you just grab the tip of your knife. And that would be a pinch. So in this case, if you need 2 pinches, then you do this twice, just as a reference so that it makes it easier and you don't have to spend on measuring spoons if you don't want to. That would be the equivalent. And let me show you. I was kind of hungry and I thought I would open a blood orange, and look at how bloody this one turned out. A vampire would probably love it, I think. It's super bloody. But okay, getting back to the recipe. We're going to use our mixer and we're going to use the globe attachment, and we're going to add our butter, room temperature, and we're going to whip it. Once it's whipped, we add our sugar and we continue mixing in there until it's mostly as best dissolved as possible. Then we add our orange juice and our 4 egg yolks. We continue mixing, and then we're going to add our flour. You can add it by spoonfuls. No need to sift, nothing complicated with this recipe. It's quite simple. After that, we add our salt, our baking powder, and the zest of our oranges, and we continue mixing until it's well integrated, and that would be it for now. Okay, so we are going to need a rolling pin. If you have dough strips, they make it much easier so that you have the same thickness in your dough when you spread it out. If not, what you need is about 1/4 of an inch or 1/2 centimeter thick, the way you roll out your dough, the thickness. So we roll out our dough, and then we're going to cut it out in any shape you guys want. I'm going to cut out little hearts. And while we are doing that, or before we do that, what we have to do is preheat our oven at 160 degrees Celsius or 320 degrees Fahrenheit. And while it's heating up, we can be cutting up our cookies. Okay, so we are done cutting our cookies. They're all on baking trays lined with baking paper. We're going to bake them for 20 minutes at 160 degrees Celsius or 320 Fahrenheit, which is the temperature we preheated. And while they're baking, in a bowl, put your confectioner sugar. You're going to add your orange juice, which has this funny red color because of the blood orange. And you are going to whisk it until you get a nice thick glaze. You need the glaze ready because once the cookies are out of the oven, you're going to put it on the cookies while they're still hot. So just with a brush, go over all the top of your cookies, leave them on the tray, and so they're all perfectly coated with this delicious glaze. Okay, so you guys, the glazing, however much you want to put on the cookie is perfectly fine. Just keep in mind that if you put a heavy coat, the cookie's gonna look much prettier. Let me show you. Here, let's grab this one. Look at how pretty the color is. It's from the orange juice. It's the natural pink color that the juice gives the glazing. It's beautiful. And the more glazing you put, the darker, the more pink the cookie looks, which it's quite pretty. If you think your glazing is too thick, you can add a bit more orange juice, mix it in there until you have the consistency you want, but don't add too much liquid, otherwise it's too drippy and it'll just go off your cookie and smear everywhere. It won't stay on the cookie. These types of oranges you can only get during winter. It's not a summer fruit or a spring fruit or an autumn fruit. It's strictly winter. So that's why I wanted to share the recipe. It's the only time of the year we can enjoy these types of oranges. But don't forget that if you can't find them where you live, because I'm aware that not every country has these types of oranges, just use a regular orange and it's going to be super yummy. It's not a complicated recipe. You don't need to chill the dough. You don't need a cooling rack. Super, super simple, as you saw. So I hope you guys enjoy the recipe from Mex Mundo Kitchen. Don't forget to subscribe and I'll see you guys in the next video.